Good morning! It's day 9. Where has the time gone? Look, the sun is out. There's a woman. Oh, it's a woman playing a bagpipe. Because women can do that too, you know? Today is going to be a good day. I can already feel it. I'm going to completely write off the incident yesterday with We Are Kilter. Just agree to disagree. I feel quite quirky today. I had a lovely, lovely tweet from Cheer Up Charlie. Isn't that amazing? He's on his way to dance with Lady Williams, who's incredible. And he's wearing my t-shirt, which honestly fills me with joy. He's such a cute little kid. Such a good response reaction to this whole campaign, Cheer Up Charlie, has been incredible. And I'm glad to have now become a little part of it. So I'm here at the Pleasance, where I've just seen a French farce called FishBowl. Now this is winning loads of awards. I'm selling out in the Pleasance main grand space, which is huge. So that's not an easy feat, but I can see why it has an appeal, and certainly an international appeal, having come from France last year. It is basically a... I don't really know how to describe it. If you know Mr. Bean, I think that's a good summary of it. It is a comedy farce with no words and hilarious set pieces. And it is quite well observed and very, very funny. Although I did feel it was a little bit long. At an hour and 15 minutes, it's something I could probably digest about 25, 30 minutes tops. And it did begin to drag. Not to say I didn't enjoy it, and it isn't brilliant. And I, like I say, because there is no language barrier, they are onto a winner. This is a show that will sell well, universally. But yeah, I'm glad I saw it. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it. But then I was never the biggest Mr. Bean fan, to be honest. I've grabbed myself a little chicken Caesar salad from Tesco's. Healthy. Oh, and a crispy creme donut. Not so healthy. I'm now on my way to see a play called Anything With a Pulse. I was meant to go and see it yesterday, but it was sold out. So I'm back today and I've reserved a ticket, so I will definitely get in. It's only a small venue, 20 seats. So I'm looking forward to it. It's been recommended by my friend Paul. So we'll see. I've just been to see Anything With a Pulse, which is a cute little two-hander. It's in the same venue where I saw Smoke yesterday. And it's very similar in that it deals with a couple who, and their first encounter, this time it's in a nightclub. They play with the convention a little bit differently as a performance. They're doing basically, in a kind of Fleabag-esque way, they kind of do asides to the audience, and as well as that, they kind of do these, it's kind of a narrative of themselves. Rather than speak to each other, they kind of describe in narrative the scenes, and then play each other's adjacent characters. So for example, the girl's best friend is played by him, and then his best friend is played by her. And these parts, I kind of felt let it down a little bit, because they do that cliche thing of trying to create identities for each different character just by putting on a phony accent. Some of them worked, some of them didn't. Generally, the performances were good, if a little erratic, and animated at points. Generally, the writing was good. I enjoyed it. It was a bit generic in places. So it was kind of a cliche look at male and female perspectives of the same event, which has been done before. But yeah, nonetheless, there was definitely some things I recognised in it and enjoyed in it. And on the whole, it was good. So I'm just at the space where I've just seen the Chanticleer players in The Mystery of Bonnie Sporran and Loch Ness Monster. It was really, really good. It was kind of that kind of Famous Five, Secret Seven vibe. All very, very English and proper. Very funny. There are lots of cheeky innuendos in there. But really well cast. Look at that. But yeah, really, really well cast. Everybody in it. There were 9 players. And they all looked apart. They all acted really well. They all had great comic timing. Really, really good. And it was a nice, neat little story. So I also made time to interview Tom and Denis from the Choir of Man. I had my pick of the 9 boys, and they were my favourites. I'm kidding. They were the only 2 that agreed to do it. Anyway, here's what they had to say.
Explain the show in your own words. How would you describe it to an audience who hasn't seen it?
Our little promo line is that it was the best pub gig you've ever been to. But so we do 9 guys singing in perfect harmony. Always perfect harmony.
Always?
No. not for me anyway. Sorry, Jack, our musical arranger supervisor. But we sing, do covers of songs, sort of like the Choir of Man, sort of mashups of songs. So it's kind of got that sort of folky, poppy feel to some of them, turning some of them on their head, mixing songs together.
So they're all songs people know, like Adele, Chandelier by Sia, and you do reimagined versions of them,
aren't
you?
Within the world of these, if there was a group of guys in a pub and they broke into the song, where would that fit into their narrative on that night in that pub? You know, whether they're at the urinal with the lads, what song might go in there, whether they're thinking about the girl, whether they're ordering their next pint, whether they're, you know, having just a sing song together. That sort of has the sort of narrative that goes on.
The full interview is on my website.
So I've just stopped to get a quick burger and a milkshake.
So I've just been to see a play called How to Mend the World with a Student Play. And it was actually quite good. It had moments of genius. It felt very much like something Ricky Gervais would write and Stephen Merchant. And the guy in it called Francis, I think that was probably to his detriment, because he probably gets compared to Stephen Merchant a lot for the fact that he's tall, lanky, and has that kind of dry sense of humour. But I think he played on that a bit too much, I think because the comparison was there, it just felt like he was a bit of a poor imitation. Not to say he wasn't good, he was just a bit, yeah. The other guys, the boys, Ollie and Joshua, I think it was, were very good, very good. Their performances were more understated and it paid off because, to me, they were quite funny. And they were very good. It was Tilly, the girl who, she was great and had lots of energy. But at times it just felt she was trying too hard. And yeah, trying to make us laugh. And being outrageous. Which was in the character, I get that. But I think if she just kind of reined it in a bit, and I think it would have paid off a little bit more. Because like I said, overall, it was funny. It was well written. It was a very clever idea. So basically, the concept is very good. And it kind of fits along. It's up there with these programs like Extras and The Office, where you kind of get this insight into these kind of barmy, off-the-wall characters who are trying to put on a play. So yeah, the conceit is good. It just wasn't quite there in the delivery or the execution. But good effort, yeah. The other thing I will say though, there were a lot of people in the audience who were other performers from the space. You can tell because they all have the lanyard on. And there were two in particular who were sat on the front row. And either they were drunk or they were deranged because they were just so annoying, laughing at every sentence. Literally, they were like two giggling schoolgirls laughing at everything. And it was a bit, and I'll be honest, it was a bit off-putting. So I tried to kind of zone them out. I mean, I'm sure they were having a great time, but it was annoying as hell. But it just does go to show how an audience can impact your enjoyment of a show. Like I say, if I'd just been watching that in an empty room, I think it would have been completely different. And it was a full audience. But yeah, those two girls. I don't know, I want to find out what show they were in so I can go and watch it and laugh all the way through theirs. I mean, it was a very supportive audience, I'll put it that way. So that's it for today. It's been a really good day. I've really enjoyed it. I'm now going to go to bed because I am absolutely knackered. Good night.